Guys, so a lot of people have been asking me about my ink, my recent ink, and it's my sleeves aren't even a quarter of the way done. But altogether, I've spent I think on a 50 hours, over 50 hours under the needle. So I can give you a little bit of advice, including how to avoid it hurting too much, and some tips on what to avoid in terms of really wrecking your tattoo or even getting shitty tattoos, and how to look after them, because I think that the aftercare process is just as important as the planning and actual getting inked itself. So let me go over a couple things here. A few things to avoid. One thing I would say, you really got to know who is tattooing you. I got one here back in about 07, I think it was, that I'm not happy with, the story behind it and everything. It's a respect to my grandfather and the sacrifice that he made, and always remembering where you come from and that sort of thing. But I'm gonna get rid of it and do it and redo it somewhere nicer, because I'm not happy with the artwork. It bled out. I wasn't told how to look after it. I was, my first tattoo, so I've learned a lot since then. I've got my whole back done. I spent about 40 hours under the needle for that, and I can give you a couple of tips to really keep your shit nice and clean and not have the ink fall out. Because of this one, it sort of bled out a bit, and the ink fell out in different places, and it's not very cool at all. Flex opportunity right there, yes. But on this stuff here, I've really learned. This one I did about a month ago. Then I went over to Thailand for about 3 weeks, avoided the sun is one thing I'm gonna mention. And then did this bit in pieces as well, which comes out to there, and I'm right about to do this one this Friday. So anyways, my point being is that you gotta know who's tattooing you. You've gotta sort of observe them, look at their other work, see how particular they are, see how much attention they pay to detail, if they rush it or if they do stupid shit. I was talking to somebody who wants to get bruised and really gets the guys to dig it in, and he bleeds heaps and worse. I'm like, fuck, that stuff just, it's just messy and it's unnecessary. If you look after your shit afterwards, the aftercare process, which I'll talk about in a second, that really keeps your shit nice and neat. So, as well as the actual artist doing his work at the same, as well. But, one other thing you really got to avoid is sunlight. Okay, you really got to keep your shit out of the sun, because it fades really easy, especially in that first bit, especially in that first week to a month, both around that time, really really crucial times. Another thing you got to avoid for about the first three, I usually do for 4 or 5 days actually, is do not wash your shit with soap. Just run water over it and reapply Bepanthen. Now I'm going to give you a link, or it's actually just spelled Bepanthen as you can see below, but you can search for it, and it's actually for nappy rash, okay, and for babies obviously, but it was recommended to me by a student, and it has proven to be the best shit ever. Some people say avoid Vaseline, some people say use Vaseline. I've used Vaseline, I've used Bepanthen, and it's the shit, I'm telling you. So I went to Thailand just recently. I was traveling a lot. It was really hard, because it's winter here, it's freezing cold, it's like 2 or 3 degrees, and then in Thailand it was 35 and Celsius. And so it was hard to put on different layers and take them off. But with Bepanthen, it keeps your shit all wet, and it could be a little bit uncomfortable for the beginning. I just wrapped my stuff in Glad wrap, like cooking wrap, whatever you want to call it, and just dealt with it. I didn't really mind. But not once did the ink fall out. Like I said, this one did in different parts, but not once did that ink actually fall out. It's still nice and very neat. It's not bled through or bled out or anything like that, and it's stayed very very neat. So as I said, it's only a quarter of the way done, but I just wanted to show you how it's going along, because a lot of people are asking me about it. It's just been insane. So that's one thing. Again, avoid washing it with soap, because the soap can take that ink out. And I guess another thing is any exercise, any strenuous exercise. So once you, because you're getting cut, you're actually, it's scarring. A lot of people scab it up, or let it scab up, sorry, and let it do its thing. But that's how your ink falls out. And everyone thinks that that's just what happens, but you can avoid that with Bepanthen and just keep putting that shit on. As soon as you feel it drying up, whatever, just keep putting it on. Same thing here, this one here, just got done last Friday, only 3 or 4 days ago now. You can see a little bit coming out because of how much that rubs up against itself, and the crease in the arm of your clothes and stuff, it rubs up on it, and it dries out a lot easier. So, but that's not really falling out. I actually haven't washed that yet. As I said before, you can see some ink sort of left over. It's not bled through, it's just still sticking there because I just kept rubbing it on. I've rinsed it off with water, but once you wash that out after about the fourth or fifth day, you'll see stuff like that that looks like it's bleeding through sort of just come straight off, and you'll be left with that nice clean line. So it's exactly what happened here. It didn't look very good at the start, But you know, I know from experience, once you get to about that fourth or fifth day and you wash all your shit off, and then you can just start applying this sort of this cream. This is actually a Vaseline type cream. You know, it actually starts looking really good. But again, you really need to avoid sunlight, and again, strenuous exercise or moving around too much, especially if it's on your arms, you're always doing this. Your skin sort of expands a lot, and what'll happen there is it'll start to crack up and fall out. And again, that's exactly what happened with this one here. So the back, I really took my time with that one. You can see some other photos or my other videos on it. It's a whole back piece. I just can't be bothered ripping it out right now. But it's really nice, you know, it's some really good work on that. It's really worth the time put in, and it's on you for life, unless you're gonna be bothered getting lasered these days, and it costs about, you know, 10 times the amount, and it's 10 times the pain, so, you know, that may change. But my point is, yeah, that's one thing about aftercare and how to avoid getting shitty tattoos, because even I've seen some good jobs out there, guys haven't looked after it, and I was just talking to my tattoo artist the other day on Friday about it, and she was saying that, yeah, all the time people just don't give a fuck about it afterwards. They go out in the sun, or they just wash it out, and then it just all falls out, and you either got to go and do it again, or if you're going to leave it like that, you're going to look like a fucking idiot. So anyways, that's some quick tips for the tattooing. I've got other videos on it about irezumi or wabori specifically, Japanese tattooing, on this channel, so definitely check that out, and share this video if you think it might help somebody out. So thanks for watching. If you haven't already, subscribe.